In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Good evening, everyone. This evening we celebrate the Vigil Mass for the solemnity of Mary, the Holy Mother of God, solemnity which is celebrated every year on the 1st of January. 1st of January is also recognized by the Universal Church as World Day of Peace. So we begin our Mass this evening by pausing for a moment to call to mind our sins and to ask for God's blessings in the new year. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who through the fruitful virginity of Blessed Mary bestowed on the human race the grace of eternal salvation, grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her through whom we were found worthy to receive the author of life, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord spoke to Moses and said, Say this to Aaron and his sons, This is how you are to bless the sons of Israel. You shall say to them, May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord let his face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord uncover his face to you and bring you peace. This is how they are to call down my name on the sons of Israel, and I will bless them. The word of the Lord. O God, be gracious and bless us.
God, be gracious and bless us.
God, be gracious and bless us, and let your face shed its light upon us. So will your ways be known upon earth, and all nations learn your saving help.
O God, be gracious and bless us.
Let the nations be glad and exult, for you rule the world with justice. With fairness you rule the peoples, you guide the nations on earth.
O God, be gracious and bless us.
Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. May God still give us his blessing till the ends of the earth revere him.
O God, be gracious and bless us.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. When the appointed time came, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born a subject of the law, to redeem the subjects of the law, and to enable us to be adopted as sons. The proof that you are sons is that God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, the Spirit that cries, Abba, Father, and it is this that makes you a son. You are not a slave anymore, and if God has made you son, then he has made you heir. The word of the Lord. Please stand to acclaim the gospel.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
At various times in the past and in various different ways, God spoke to our ancestors through the prophets. But in our own time, the last days, he has spoken to us through his Son.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The shepherds hurried away to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger. When they saw the child, they repeated what they had been told about him, and everyone who heard it was astonished at what the shepherds had to say. As for Mary, she treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds went back, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was exactly as they had been told. When the eighth day came and the child was to be circumcised, they gave him the name Jesus, the name the angel had given him before his conception. The Gospel of the Lord. The response to our prayers of intercession this evening is, Lord, give peace to all your people. Blessed be the Lord Jesus, our bond of peace with one another. He came to make the Jews and Gentiles one people. Let us therefore pray. Lord Jesus, you revealed the meaning of human living. May we never fail to give thanks for all you have given us. You made Mary your mother, full of grace. Enrich with your blessings the life of everyone on this earth. You proclaim the gospel to the world. May your word in all its power penetrate into the hearts of all people. You became, through Mary, the brother of everyone. Teach us to love one another. We pray for the sick, for all who are poorly in mind or body, at home, nursing home, or in hospital. And we pray through the intercession of Our Lady of Lourdes that Christ, the Good Shepherd, may strengthen, encourage, and sustain all those whose health is a touch vulnerable at this time. We pray in a special way also this evening for all those families, particularly in our own parish, who are mourning the loss of a loved one, asking at Mass this evening that God will replace their sense of loss and desolation with his very own divine support and divine consolation. We pray for all who are suffering the consequences of the current coronavirus pandemic, that God the Father may grant health to the sick, strength to those who care for them, comfort to families, and salvation to all the many victims throughout the world who have died. We pray for a moment in silence for those who have asked for prayers, for those we have promised to pray for, and for those who have no one left to pray for them. You came like the dawn of a new day. Show to the dead the radiance of your presence. And we remember in a special way this evening Connor Mulholland, Kevin Coleman, Kieran Killips, and Phelan Morgan, all of whose anniversaries occur today. We also pray for Barney Hamill, Alice Murphy, Maureen Fisher, William Black, Miriam McNally, Barry Dugan, Seamus McKeever, Hugh Campbell, Pat Hughes, Arthur Wilson, and Noel Liggett, all of whose anniversaries occur tomorrow, the 1st of January. Let us pray. God our Father, since you gave humanity a Saviour through Blessed Mary, Virgin and Mother, grant that we may feel the power of her intercession when she pleads for us with Jesus Christ, your Son, the author of life, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in your kindness begin all good things and bring them to fulfilment, grant to us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory in the beginnings of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in its completion through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name as we commemorate the solemnity of Mary, the Mother of God. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise, as we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Eamon, our Bishop, Michael, his assistant bishop, Sean, our retired bishop, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever. At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. May this mingling of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. O sacred heart of Jesus, immaculate heart of Mary, we invoke the intercession of our Heavenly Mother in this her solemnity, praying for protection from the coronavirus in the coming weeks and months, as we pray together the Memorare. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to your protection, implored your help, or sought your intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto you. O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother, to you do I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your clemency, hear and answer me. Amen. And for protection tonight, O angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love commits thee here, ever this night be at my side, to light, to guard, to rule and guide. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. May they rest in peace. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Let us pray. We have received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life. For we rejoice to proclaim the Blessed Ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church, through Christ our Lord. Just before the final blessing, just to let you remind you that Mass tomorrow is at midday, but just to ensure safety, we decided that it would just be streamed live at 12 o'clock. There'll be no Mass tomorrow evening, and also just to wish everyone a very happy and holy new year. And please God, 2021 will bring us many blessings and better days than maybe 2020 has provided us with. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Let us go in the peace of Christ.